Here are two more examples of combining like terms given an expression. Here we have x squared y plus 3xy squared plus 4x squared y. Remember, like terms have to have the exact same variable part, which means they must contain the exact same variable factors. So analyzing these three terms very closely, notice only the first term and the third term are like terms because they're the only two terms that contain two factors of x and one factor of y. So these are the only two terms that we can combine. And now we know that to combine like terms, we add or subtract the coefficients or the numbers in front of the variables. Well, x squared y doesn't appear to have a coefficient, but it does. Remember, multiplying by 1 doesn't change anything, so we can think of this as 1x squared y. So 1x squared y plus 4x squared y would be equal to 5x squared y. And then we still have the plus 3xy squared. So be careful with problems like this and make sure the terms have the exact same variable factors. For the second example, we have negative 7m minus 4 plus 2m plus 9. Well, the first term has one factor of m, and so does the third term, so those are like terms. Notice the second term and fourth term are constants, and constants are also like terms, so we can combine these two terms as well. So negative 7m plus 2m would be negative 5m because, looking at the coefficients, negative 7 plus 2 is equal to negative 5, and the variable part stays the same. And then for minus 4 plus 9, if we need to, we can think of minus 4 as plus negative 4, and since negative 4 plus 9 would be positive 5, we would have plus 5. So these two examples were a little bit more involved. We'll take a look at two more examples in the next video where we have distribution as well as combining like terms.